Hey guys, Blue Ryan Tiger here. Now, back with Siberia Tree with Squiddy. Apparently, now we've got the captain to sober up, and now we're supposed to take the boat to get the Yukles. And, Sarah's grandfather, Steiner, will go get Kirk's leg and take it to the clinic for him. So things are lining up for us to leave, but it's probably not as all as it seems to be. And make Beavers be more choppy. Excuse me. You know, you stick an SSD in this thing and it takes forever to load. Okay, let's go find the captain. Captain, I need to find you. Oh, maybe we can go over. Oh, boat. I mean, chairs. Yeah, genial boats. Trash can? Probably. Oh, this looks like a icebreaker blade right here. Tingy. That's an interesting feature for that to have. And that's some type of winch. Yeah, let's check inside. He may be there. A mold? Am I gonna have to worry about getting sick? He's probably in the upper thing. So, I gotta figure out how to get to the top.
Nobody.
I can't go around there, so I gotta go back this way. Yeah, we gotta go in here. There's somebody else here. Aha. Well, it sounds like a boat. You run inside the boat, but you won't run around in the tavern, okay. You. Just weirdy, Kate. Let's go to the workbench first. Nothing to do here. But I'm assuming we're gonna have to start the ship up ourselves. Actually, no. Go back down. There's one more thing to do. I forgot about this. That door we didn't get, actually.
This would be perfect for the Yukels.
Oh, cargo bay, okay. His boiler is empty? Okay, now we need to find out how to get upstairs. There we go. That's what we need. You know, red lights and your moldy walls. That's a horror story waiting there to happen. And I would know because I read No Sleep on Reddit. Yuppie. Ahem, you and your bottles, Captain. Nice stove, though.
It looks like it needs repairs. Too bad.
Apparently, when Kate thinks to herself now, she just keeps her mouth, her physical mouth shut. Is this the captain's log? Yes, it is the captain's log. Let us read the captain's log. Wait, you have to, Oh, okay. I am a man, and because I err, I am a man, okay? Ah, so this is apparently this Kraken's eyes. Sea squid, look. That doesn't look quite like your eyes. This is what a real one looked like. Big, round dinner plate thing. This thing looks something like a cuttlefish, actually. Because they have that flap of skin that goes over the their eye, like a kind of like those frog and stuff. Let's see. Yeah, he's complaining that he had an easy job, but that one messed him up. Okay. I'll read that later. Interesting. But we know something now. He did pick this because it was an easy job. What do we have here? Easy shotgun, yes?
Alright, Captain. How are the preparations going?
There's quite a bit of work to do before we can hoist the anchor, Miss Kate.
Maybe I can help you out with something.
Well, the coal needs to be stocked up. As for myself, I'll look after getting the water tanks ready to be filled. Take this. It's the code you need for entering the hangar where the coal is kept. You actually need it to use the crane to load the coal onto the crystal. Don't forget to open the storage hatchway first.
How do I open the hatchway to the coal storage on the crystal?
Just turn the wheel on the ship's bridge, sailor.
What do I need the crane for?
This here is for loading all the coal you get from the hangar onto the ship. Use the code I gave you so that you can access the control post.
What do I need to do in the hangar?
That's where you'll find all the coal you need for the crystal. One container should just about be enough. And don't forget to use the entry code for the crane that I just gave you.
Okay, so we need
I'll
to
take care of that, Captain.
We need to set sail as soon as possible, so better hurry up.
Hey, a little smile. Okay. I like when she makes a little smile. Documents, maybe? 0509, okay. Let's get off the boat. Okay, so this should hopefully shouldn't take too long. This thing. Turning we okay. I think that's it. I don't think there's any other here? No? Okay. Let's get off to Crystal. So yeah, people were talking about this game that it's mediocre. They were actually mad. You had to they're actually mad you had to walk around. They're also mad that whatchamacallit. That yeah, they're just dissatisfied. And apparently some people have beaten it already over me. Oops. I cleared that back. I didn't do that right. So they're just mad in general. They say you had so much years to do this and you couldn't do it right, kind of thing. And also, like you saw, some of the dialogue was misspelled. So I do agree that it's not up to level. But still, let's try to have some fun with it. Oh no, wait, we need to have that first to get the cart to there, and then we switch the cart. Kate, you're strong. Need something around here probably to open those. No? Okay, invisible barrier. Aha. Okay, no, don't do that. So what you have to do is line it back up. With shoot. Now we need to use the button. It's empty. Okay, let's see, shoot with this. Okay, let's check something for a second. So this is random, from what I understand. Some don't have it, some do, and nobody knows if it's which one it is for sure. So there we go. Okay, yeah, I figured Kate wouldn't be able to push that, but just have to make sure. Okay, let's get off here and look for something else. Who dumped a minecart in the corner there? I need to go back here. This, we turn it that way, so now it'll, when it goes, it'll go around the team. And there's nothing in here. Yes. What's this? Crowbar! Kate is gonna conk someone. If she can run in a straight line first. Oh, so wait, what happened to the bar? Are we supposed to do something with that? Okay, so this one broke my brain. Apparently, you have to, use your knife.
Not a chance.
to bust the button off. And then you put this one here. Okay, so it's good green. Where did the cutscene? Now we gotta figure out how to use a crane. Okay, this shouldn't be too hard. I hope not. So yeah, I'm looking to possibly... I've gotten hooked on a mobile game, as dumb as that sounds. I've been playing... let's see, first let's get over here. So before I lose my thoughts, because I'm not good at talking and typing too much and playing. Okay, maybe you have to run to this one? Oh no, wait. I just remembered there was a control panel on the ground. That probably has something to do with it. Yes, this thing. Oh, you can run across that. Okay. Okay, shortcut. Okay, so apparently dumb me wasn't looking in the right part of the thing. And yeah, I did have to reference this. It took a bit because not a lot of people have played this game yet. So the control panel, same control panel, but it's on the freaking end of the crane on the other side. And unlike the old Siberias where you can just click anywhere, I know you still have to run up to it, but yeah, you have to be right next to this part of the crane before it works. So same code. Zero. Bop. Okay, let's just try this again, because I hit 2 instead of 5. 0, 5, 0, 9. Excuse me. Okay. Now we take the ladder. And we go up. Can't go anymore. That actually looks about right. I don't know what that does. Okay. Let's hit back to this one. Switch CCTV. Go this way. Okay. This back this way. We're getting there. This way? Here. Congratulations, Kate. You did a job in 10 minutes that would have taken a dock worker 2 months to do.
Apparently, you did a very good job loading all the coal, Kate. Right. Everything's ready, so we can start filling the water tank. Now, we need to connect the water tower to the crystal, then climb up there to manually activate the water flow mechanism.
Let me guess. You're counting on me?
When you're finished, come and see me on board. There's still a lot to do before we're shipshape.
So we have to go here. I do apologize for drinking a lot of stuff. I'm just trying to just keep awake. Because most of the time I film now, it's nighttime. Okay. Dunking poor thing get. Oh, come on. Aha. Kate doing all this mechanical labor. Oops. There might be an issue, I'm not sure. Okay, apparently now we have both the coal hopper and we have fuel and we have coolant, I'm guessing, or just plain old water. But I'm guessing the water is for the boilers for steam. So we have both. Now let's see what the captain wants. Now we can go.
I took care of the water, Captain. Everything went smoothly. Is everything okay?
No. The ignition key for the crystal. I can't find it anywhere. Without it, we can't even start.
Come on, just relax. The key has to be around here somewhere.
Good Lord, now I remember. 20 years ago. When I got back from Baranor without the automatons, everybody was really very hard on me, you know.
Captain, I don't really see what you...
So I spent the whole night in the tavern. You should have seen the state I was in when I got back to the Bridge of the Crystal and...
And?
And then I threw the crystal's ignition key into the water. I swore I'd never set sail on the cursed waters of the lake again.
I saw a model of the crystal at Simon's Diners. Is he the one who designed the ship?
Yes, of course.
Maybe he could be of some help then.
Maybe. Who knows?
There has to be a duplicate for the key.
I don't know. At any rate, when Steiner finished building the crystal, he only actually gave me the one.
So that's it? The ignition key is lost forever?
Yeah. I'm afraid so. I'm really sorry, Kate, but we're stuck. I've made a complete mess of everything again. Again.
Don't be so hard on yourself, Captain. I'll find a solution to the key problem.
If you say so.
Okay, so we have to go back to Steiner's place and meet his lovely granddaughter again. And, go find it, because obviously we're not gonna go scuba diving for a key. So apparently he hasn't used his boat in 2 decades. Interesting. I sense all is not well, though, because those people have to figure out sooner or later where we went. The detective, the mercenary warlord person. Run, Kate, run! I am Sinistar. I hunger. Roar! I think I did it right. I heard that from a Phoenix Wrong video when I started getting into anime in 2008. A delightful Zelda fan showed me a video with a bunch of Phoenix Wright clips, and they superimposed them with sounds of different things. And one of them was from an old game called Sinistar. Oh, it's this thing here. And he... It was... some weird thing, and you had to fight this thing called Sinistar, and he had these really cheesy voice lines. But at the time, the effect was okay, I guess. Steiner, we need a key. Okay. Another Steiner that comes to mind. Klaus Steiner, Starlancer, German head pilot they usually do with head ops sometimes in different missions. So that comes to mind too, and I'm thinking about this guy. Okay.
Kate, how are the preparations with the captain coming along?
We're making progress, but actually we need some help from your grandfather. Is he here?
He just left for the clinic with the artificial leg he made for the Yuko guide, Kirk. I'm minding the shop until he gets back. Maybe I can help you with something?
Actually, we need a duplicate of the crystal's ignition key.
I have to admit, I don't see where you could get one of those. Apart from the model downstairs, I don't think he kept a lot of souvenirs of the time when he built the crystal.
Would you mind if I had a look?
Of course not. Here, take this. It'll let you look at the model close up.
Okay, not bad. I keep binding the shop, Sarah. Good job. Carry on, or whatever. I forgot the phrase that was in my head.
Impossible.
Crystal, 2 years and 98 days of labor. Huh, puzzle, okay. We apparently have to do something with this. Let's see what else is here.
Fantastic! Fantastic!
Well, the plaque did say 30. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. No, I'm trying to get it to 70. Okay, so 30 is a trigger. This is going to be a sequential compilation. So 30 is the first combination. Maybe 50? Okay, no. So try 30 and 70. Okay, 30, 70. Ten wasn't it? Let's try 50. Dang it. I didn't do it right. The hell? It's supposed to be 30. Then 70. Just like it did just now. Okay, let's try this again. Go back again. Actually, no, let's look back at that plaque. The plaque may have a clue. Instead of me having to go hard code it. 2 years and 98 days. 60. Okay. Okay, there we go. Okay. 30. I think it's not quite 30, it's not quite 70, maybe 75. Like here. Okay, so it's 30, 80 actually. 30, 80. Okay, this may take a bit. Just do hang on. I might cut some of this. didn't try 3867, I believe. Oh, okay, I missed it. You didn't try 386. Okay, let me look back at this thing. There may be a clue we're missing. Turtle was the first one. Ito was the next one. 60's the next one. But there's no 100. Turtle, Eater, 60. Okay, so what you had to do in this passage was
an ignition key. But it looks far too small for the crystal.
Okay, so the pass with the key was, and it's cleverly hidden, so you guys, in case you guys get stuck on this, the password is 3080 60 100, and 100 is not marked on the dial. And basically, if you get lost with the clue, read the plaque and read backwards each number that goes. So there we go. So the machine for this. Excuse me? Oh, come on, close. Okay, it said 50% on there. Mm. Okay. So let's take our key blank. Put it here. Go back. I think that's the power button. There's supposed to be a cutscene. That should be the right
size. Duplication worked, but I get the impression it's not the right size.
Oh, come on, Kate. My math isn't usually off with these things, but we'll try another key. It's 50% of the original high. What do you mean you need to make it 200% to make it normal? Okay, let's give that one a crack. Okay, we'll see. Okay, that's it. That's what you have to do. Simple math, guys. Simple math. Oh, wait, something else. This is a messy workshop. Hey, can you talk to her anyway else?
Don't worry. As soon as Grandfather gets back here with Kirk, I'll tell them to join you straight away on the crystal.
Okay. I think we're actually getting to a point we're going to wrap it up. But let's start the crystal up before we do that. Oh, come on, Kate. See, the controls are a little wonky with this. Tested guy. Okay. Let's go talk to Captain Boar, I think, right? Him and his moldy walls. I don't like it when my walls are moldy. And that's the paraphrase of Dane Cook. is Kool-Aid. I don't like it when my juice wears tight.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, you fix that wall before my dad gets home. Naughty, naughty Kool-Aid. All right, here we go.
Fantastic, Kate. I have to admit, you really know how to get things done.
Thank you, Captain. Are there any other preparations to carry out?
There's just one last problem to solve. The locks we need to use to get out onto the lake. They're shut by order of the town hall. You have to find some way to get them open.
What do you suggest?
The best thing to do is to ask Mayor Bulyukin for the authorization to reopen them. But just to give you fair warning, he's about as straight as a crooked waterspout, so you mind him. Or you could just get a hold of some explosives and then kaboom!
First I'll try talking to the mayor. Thanks, Captain.
I would have just done kaboom. So the mayor may be in a different spot. Why don't we get out this way? It's controls. The mayor might have something waiting for us. We gotta be careful. Oh, come on, Kate. Stop walking in the circle. Well, considering there's a water fountain here, probably not too far from town hall.
I don't have any coins. Too bad.
My dear friends, keep calm. Please, keep calm. I beg of you.
We'll calm down when we get what we want.
Yeah, Nomad's out.
Kick the Yukels out right now, or the strike will get worse.
I know just what you mean, my dear friends, and...
It's all words. We want it.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes? What now?
Excuse me, Mr. Mayor. Please forgive me for intruding like this without an appointment at all, but I'd just like to start off by saying thank you for your time. I know how precious it is.
You are completely forgiven, my dear lady. How can I help?
Do you think it would be possible to open the locks in the port?
I beg your pardon? Did you say the locks? What on earth for?
I'm actually accompanying the Yukul tribe on their long journey right now, Mr. Mayor. I've asked Captain Obo if he would take us to the other side of the lake on the crystal to now dusk.
Oh, Captain Obo. The crystal. The Yukuls. Do go on. Anyway, it would be very ungracious of me if I were to criticize you for removing that burden from our good town. Nonetheless, I'm afraid I must refuse your request, dear lady. The locks will remain closed until further notice. This decision came from above, you understand?
It's obvious the mayor is afraid of his superiors, but he's also afraid he'll lose votes.
My time is precious, in case you haven't noticed.
I'm really sorry to say this, Mr. Mayor, but are you absolutely certain that's the right decision?
What do you mean?
Well, you know that making the Yukul stay here by keeping the locks closed is clearly not what the people in your administration want. They won't understand. In the long run, there could be backlash at election time.
Now that I think about it, yes. You are right. And I have always been there for my voters. But the orders. Their orders, understand?
I need to remind him where his power base lies.
I'm listening, my dear lady.
You're the mayor, and it's you and you alone who can decide what's right for Valsumbur. So why not reassert your authority once and for all? Authorize the opening of the locks.
I could do it, of course. But it's complicated, understand?
Just open the darn thing, Mr. Mayor.
Well then, what is it?
He has to see that the fate of the Yukuls depends on his decision.
I'm listening, dear lady.
Open your eyes and see past your regulations and petty procedures. Don't you see that the fate of the Yukul caravan depends on your decision? If they don't come with me as soon as possible, their ostriches will lose patience and try to swim across the lake. It'll be a disaster. The entire herd could drown.
Well, I have to admit, dear lady, that your arguments have convinced me. I am authorizing you to open the port locks so the crystal can leave.
Yes, we did it.
Nonetheless, you should know that there is a technical problem that means the locks have to be opened manually. I imagine that such an inconvenience isn't likely to deter a woman as determined and resourceful as you.
Do you mean that?
Yes, as the local technician is absent, I'm afraid you'll have to delve into the murky waters yourself to open the locks. Nonetheless, this should help you use the underwater mechanism.
But how am I supposed to dive?
That, dear lady, is your problem, I suppose. Do have an excellent day.
Oh, so we probably do get to go dive after all. Well, we got what we wanted, and what I should have actually done is, take the, other approach. What's this? You have clones for policemen? Look at this. They all look the same. You're reusing models. Okay, so we have to just run out of here. Oh, you can't run through little concrete blocks like that. Okay. Hey, bird. What is around the square anyway? Well, they had snow. Just see what's up here quick. A railway. Looks kind of like a mass driver a little bit. This bird, oh okay. It looks like you're flying in place, she said. Let's get out of here and hit the extra boat. I really wish there was a fast travel option. An Assassin's Creed. Oh, come on. Yeah, I'm pretty much close to wrapping up at this point. It's just a lot of back and forth, just like the old Siberia games. Shut
well,
up, too.
The mayor gave us authorization to open the locks, but I have to do it manually, by diving down into the port.
I can probably help. There should still be some old diving equipment you can use in that shed at the end of the seawall.
I've never gone diving. But if you think I'll be fine down there, I don't mind trying.
This has to stay between the two of us, Kate. There's something you need to know about the locks. They're also there to stop the lake monster from entering the port. Anyway, that's what I heard. But at this time of day, there's no risk. That spawn of hell sleeps all day.
Do you really believe there's a monster down there in that
it's
lake?
It's there, Kate.
You know,
come on.
20 years ago, it really wasn't Paranor that I was afraid of. Not the deaths, the radiation. That's what people say, but the truth is that it was actually that damn monster that made me scoot away like a minnow. It was lurking around Paranor, drawn by the stench of the graves, probably. I saw its red eyes staring at me, Miss Walker. That's something you never forget.
Where's a suit I can use?
Meet me in the shed at the far end of the seawall. There should be something just about your size. I mean, near enough, anyway.
Underwater? How am I supposed to open the lock gates?
They're kept in place with some kind of steel locks. Just try and pull them out using their mechanism.
All right. There's nothing to it.
Meet me in the shed at the end of the seawall.
I like it. Somebody might go say, oh, you go diving. Or make the captain dive, but honestly, seeing Kate get up into a diving suit and go diving is actually quite interesting. But I'm going to cut off here because I'm a little tired and it's getting 4 o'clock here again. So, with you having two full episodes to enjoy. We'll come back again next time, and hopefully I'll have something Overwatch related to this week to upload too. So, enjoy, and I'll catch you later.